everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And today we're going to have spring cleanup part one, because I know there's going to be more than one. Well, this weather is making me dizzy. First, it's nice and just a gentle rain and the grass is getting green and it's almost 70 degrees out. And the next day we get slammed with 4 inches of snow. And by the end of the next day, the snow is gone.
And then it snows again.
And it's just like snow, winter, spring, summer, winter. I mean, it's really hard to keep up with.
Mother Nature loves to tease us.
Yes. Yes, she does. But I think it's stretching spring out, because the flowers that are coming up, the bulbs that are coming up, start coming up and they give us a little bit of flower and then it cools off, so they slow down. So I think spring is just slowing down so we can appreciate it. These are in the onion family. I don't know exactly what they're called, but if you pull them up, it smells like onions. But they're one of the very first plants to come up in the spring, and they're so welcome. We're happy to see you. Thank you for being here.
Oh, your little iris are popping up.
And the little iris. Yes.
Those are so hardy. I mean,
they
can be snowing and they're still green and
right
peeking
and
out of the
those
snow.
Are daisies that reseed themselves each year. Yeah. This, I can't remember it, but it has little white flowers on it that also is a perennial it's kind of invasive, but pretty.
So what are you going to do today?
Well, today I am going out to the very front of the house where I have little plots of daffodils coming up and blooming, but in between are the old sedums that I leave on all winter. Usually I don't chop my perennials down to the ground because I like them to catch the leaves in the snow to help insulate everything. But I don't want to see all those brown sedum heads next to my cute little daffodils. So those have to go today before it starts raining, which is imminent.
Well, let's get going.
Yes. Now this is what I'm talking about. These were my beautiful sedums, and you can see that they are coming up. They're ready, but all of this old stalky stuff is in the way. And then if you look over yonder, you'll see that the daffodils are coming up, but then you see all the brown sedum heads, which is ruining the picture.
It's really foggy out today.
Yes, it is. Let's see if this works. Yes, it does.
Kind of like you giving me a haircut.
Uh-huh.
Just chopping away.
Now in the past, I've chopped each of these off with a hand trimmer. This is much faster.
So how far down are you going to take them?
Just to the tops. I mean, they don't have to go all the way down because they will add to the support of the growing plants as they come up. I just don't want to see them.
You don't want to see sedum?
Exactly.
Now, would that make great mulch?
It is mulch, yes. And it's putting back in what the sedum has taken out as it grew last year.
You just don't want to bend down into the mud.
Well, no. Why should I? Plus, this is much faster. Several years ago, when we planted these McIntosh apple trees, this one and its sister across the driveway there, we decided we needed to keep them parallel with the road so that as we back out of the driveway, we can actually see around them. So we set up a cage and we're creating an espalier kind of training grid for them to grow on. Now that they've pretty much taken that shape, it's time to take this cage off, and that's what Rick's going to be doing while I chop perennial heads. Did you get the apple trees done?
Yes, I did.
You're really quick. Well, I think it looks better.
Definitely, yeah.
You can now focus on the daffodils and not whatever those brown things were that were left over from last year. So that's good. I like that.
That's nice to see everything peeking up through the leaves.
Now look at what's coming up over here in abundance.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Isn't that special?
Uh-huh. These are your mullins.
Yeah.
It'll get taller than me with a big stalk on them.
Maybe we need to transplant them.
Well, they're biennials, and I'm trying to think if these are the babies, they won't have stalks this year, but they'll have stalks next year.
Yeah, we could put them over along the fence line.
We could.
That'd be nice.
Sometimes under the leaves that we put down at the very last minute, you find perennials that want to come up, but they're a little bit buried. So you see the leaves did not stop them from growing, but they did slow them down a bit. Almost feels like the ground is still frozen under here.
I'm sure it is. Looked better though. Ooh. See, the rabbits have been trimming our
burning bushes.
Oh well. Then you don't have to trim them.
Keeps them under control. Because I think, I don't know what kind of burning bush this is. It might be the invasive one, but ours never get big enough to be invasive. This is a coreopsis.
You're just going wild with that trimmer this morning.
I am. It's just really nice not to have to be on my hands and knees chopping away.
I'm just trying to get this done before the rain comes.
Well, I keep saying it's going to start any minute. It's cold and windy and...
It's really damp out
damp
here.
Out,
my
yep.
goodness. This
Chicago
reminds
weather.
Me of Chicago weather, yep. I think we've been in Chicago twice when it was really nice.
Uh-huh. We'll have to try it again in June.
I guess.
Always easier to trim the grass before it starts coming up. I think this is flame grass.
Yep.
Good time to straighten out the wire.
At least the ground isn't too frozen.
No, it's good right there.
Let me check inside the book library. Yep.
Books in there?
A lot of goodies.
Now this one will have to be trimmed by hand. This is a peony, and you can't get in there, first of all, with a hedge trimmer. But I also want to make sure that I'm going down deep enough. And I'm going to be removing these old stems just so no diseases are passed along.
Would it help to remove that cage?
No. Gives me something to rest on. You can see, here they come. That's why I didn't want to do it with a bigger utensil. Yeah. But you can also see how hard it is to cut these leaves because they're very fibrous. And they don't like to just be cut with one little swift cut. They have to be chewed on.
So you chew them down?
I chew them down in case I get hungry out here.
So what are you going to do with the cuttings?
Cuttings I'm going to throw in the compost. Where's my wheelbarrow? In the wheelbarrow and then into the compost pile. There's nothing wrong with these leaves. I just don't want them around the parent plant. It's starting to rain. We made it just in time. Got to get this over to the pile, and then in we go for some hot chocolate.
Yoo-hoo!
If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We'd really appreciate it. And if you have comments or questions about what's going on in your yard, we'd love to hear about it. Also, if you'd like to become part of our garden family, please hit that little subscribe button right there. We'd love to have you. Thank you again. Stay warm. Be happy it's spring.
That could be snow.
Connect with us on YouTube.